Let's go. And we will say, oh.
Nice to be with you today, Wednesday, 7th April 2021, Wednesday of Easter week on Your Life Boy today. And we're still trying to see how we can continue every day to keep you anchored to the Word of God, to Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior, and to keep you afloat and to let you know whatever dangers may be in life, that's what a boy does. And that's what we try to do with Your Life Boy today. Today, we are, as usual, referring to the Daily Fountain, the Daily Devotional Guide of the Church of Nigeria Anglican Communion. And the topic for our discussion and for our prayers is Christ opened their minds. And we'll be taking our Bible reading from Luke chapter 24. We'll be reading from verse 44 to verse 49. Quite long too, so let's go. And he said unto them, these are the words which I spake unto you while I was yet with you, that all things must be fulfilled, which were written in the law of Moses and in the prophets, and in the Psalms concerning me. Then opened he their understanding, that they might understand the scriptures. And he said unto them, thus it is written, and thus it behoved Christ to suffer, and to rise from the dead the third day, and that repentance and remission of sins should be preached in this in his name, amongst all the nations, beginning at Jerusalem. And ye are witnesses of these things. And behold, I send the promise of my Father upon you, but ye tarry in the city of Jerusalem until ye be endued with power from on high. Of course, Jesus was telling them here about the promise of the Holy Spirit, which will take complete control after his ascension to heaven, and they, the disciples, and the rest of us, the rest of the world, would now have a full understanding with our minds completely opened to the scriptures. But at this point in time, Christ Jesus, even though he had resurrected, because he had not ascended into heaven to go and trigger off that promise of sending the Holy Spirit upon them, which was the promise he had always made, he still needed to open their minds, so that they will have a full understanding of the scriptures. Of course, like I discussed maybe 2 or 3 days ago, everything about the suffering of Christ was well spelled out in literal prophecies. If you go to Isaiah 53, you see a lot of things there. But about his resurrection, hardly would you see any of the prophets that was categorical and clear about his resurrection. And that was why infallible proofs had to be provided when he yet was on the surface of the earth, going around and letting people see him and making sure that he opened the minds of the people by further teachings of the scriptures. And that was why he needed to open their minds here again to understand all the promises that are ahead of everyone that will believe him. He needed to do that because even where I would say there was the clearest of all the references to his resurrection, which I referred to maybe about 2 or 3 days ago, that's in Psalm 16 verse 10, where David, who was a forebearer in flesh of our Lord Jesus Christ, said in the Psalms, and you know, Jesus himself referred to it here, that certain things were written about him in the Psalms. He mentioned the Psalms in verse 44 that we just read. And in the Psalms was when David said, as far back as 1,000 years even before Christ was born, that you will not leave my soul in hell, and neither will you see your Holy One to see corruption. So, but all of these things, because they were allegorical, were not too clear to the people until Christ opened their minds. So for you too, these days, in spite of the fact that you have the Holy Spirit indwelling in you, if you are a Christian, and if you are not yet a Christian, you have the chance of having that access to the Holy Spirit that can indwell in you too and teach you everything, every minute, every day of your life. But as at this time that these ones required that Christ would open their minds, you may still require from time to time that Christ will open your mind to certain things through the Holy Spirit now, which is indwelling in you. And so let that Holy Spirit that we are talking about now be more in full control concerning your own situation, because that is the way that Christ opens minds today. He drops something in your spirit, and if your spirit is well attuned to His Spirit and you're able to get the information that you require, then you're able to be in His will, and then you're able to do His will. And that is the way Christ will continually open your mind. The way He opened the minds of the disciples when He was first with them originally before His death through crucifixion was through daily teaching. But even after resurrection, He still dwelt with them. He still taught them. He still ate with them. He still moved with them, physically, so to say. And He assured them. Look at that verse 49 again. It says, "And behold, I send the promise of my Father upon you, but ye tarry in the city of Jerusalem until ye be endued with the power from on high." Of course, the power I was talking about is the same power that He went into the grave to take out. And He declared after He came out of the grave that all power in heaven and on earth had been given unto Him. That is the same power through the Holy Spirit that He passes on to you and to me today by opening our minds that way. I pray that Christ will continue to open our minds. And for those who have closed their minds to Christ, including that my friend the atheist, I pray that the Lord will touch everyone, and then you will open up your minds so that Christ would have succeeded in opening your mind as well. Now, you want to open your mind to Christ? Say this prayer after me. Say, "Oh God, I have heard again now about how you have opened the minds of your disciples. I want my mind to also be opened the more, that I may also be part of your disciples, even though not that you are here physically any longer, but to also be endued with the same kind of power of the Holy Spirit, that I may live a life that is worthy of your glory and be one of your witnesses here in my generation. I ask of this, Lord, in Jesus' name." If you have said that prayer, I know that He is willing always, and He's going to forgive you, and He's going to take you into His kingdom in Jesus' name. Now, if you have been part of that kingdom I always talk about every day, and you are one of those who had always had the Holy Spirit with you, you still need to be sure that you have an infilling of the Holy Spirit so that Christ can continue to open your mind in all situations. Say this prayer. Say, "Oh Lord, grant me the spirit of enlightenment to understand the scriptures the more, and to be able to appropriate the scriptures for my benefit, for the benefit of my generation, for the benefit of my nation, for the benefit of my family, and to the glory of your holy name. Do this for me, Lord, in the mighty name of Jesus." Go out today and let Christ open your mind that you may understand more of this world and the world to come. God bless you.
When it doesn't feel like it, say you are good. You feel my love with your goodness.